Oh, I'm getting old, getting very, very old. And I don't mind, no, I don't mind. People say old age is no place for the old. But oh, not me. I live my life in the passage, safe and sound, dark and snug as underground. Days roll on for I've given all my francs to my niece and dear Laurent.
Yeah, da, 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 da.
I am very, very happy,
da,
never
da,
fear.
Da, 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 da.
I am very, very happy, never fear, in my old age. Oh, I had a son, such a snuggy, lovely son, who was so delicate, he was so delicate. From when he was in the cradle to the very day he was so delicate. Do you remember? Do you to raise? He had measles, mumps, and vomiting, rubella, pink eye, croup, whooping cough, and tonsillitis. All he ever ate was soup. Ear infections by the score. Passage underground.
In the passage underground, days go on. In the passage underground, in the passage underground, days roll on. Days roll on. Days roll on for months underground.
I am very, very happy. Never fear. And then there's my dear Laurent, who carries me around like the dear second son that he is.
Dear Laurent,
my dear Laurent, who has such an endless strength in his huge arms. Such an endless strength in his huge young arms. Because I'm getting stiff, getting very, very stiff, and I can't get around. It started at my feet and then traveled up my legs and then into such a snuggy, lovely life with Laurent and my cat and my niece Therese. We still have our dominoes every Thursday night, and we're so content. We're just so content. I'm not scared. you see, there's such a happy pair of lovers. They look like they're bathed in golden sunlight. They are quiet as mice. The children share a bed in the room next to me.
Come on, just here.
I never hear a thing. They're so considerate. You see,
a bit of courage. You have got out of your last husband.
They like nothing more. Nothing more. It is true.
Well, and you'll see there's just a putrefied mess left in there.
True.
And maybe you won't be quite so scared.
Then to sit side by side, and they
come on, Therese. You know you love me. Give me a kiss.
Don't ask me.
Come on, just here.
Not there.
What's you shaking?
And
for?
I like.
You're not still scared of Camilla, are you?
More.
Yes, you are, aren't you? You're still careless. You are, aren't you? You're still scared of Camilla. You stupid bitch.
Then to
you haven't got a bit of courage.
Like you haven't got an ounce.
Do you think that your last husband is going to come and drag you out of bed by your feet just because you're in here with me? I shall have to take you down to the cemetery one night. We'll open up his coffin and you'll see that there's just a putrefied mess in there. That's all that's left. Then maybe you won't be quite so scared. In any case, it's not as if he knows we shoved him in the water.
You did it, you!
No, we chucked him in because he was becoming a nuisance. And we would chuck him in again if we had to, wouldn't we? So stop being so childish and get a grip on yourself. It's silly to upset our happiness like this. Don't you see, my dear, that when we're dead and buried, the fact that we shoved some poor idiot into the same won't make a blind bit of difference to what happens to us? But we will have enjoyed each other to the full. And that's the main thing. So come on, give me a kiss!
And where do you want me to kiss you? As always, there! Where Camille sank his teeth into your neck and took a lump of your flesh with him into the sea! No! Dear Mother, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Laurent, do something! I think our dear mother needs to go to bed. She's had a shock.
That's it. Go on. Take a good look at me. Your looks won't eat me.